How we doing, everybody? This is Let's Be Real Brad, and today I'm going to be talking about the sequel to the classic 1984 A Nightmare on Elm Street called A Nightmare on Elm Street 2 Freddy's Revenge. But before I start getting off into this review, hit that like button. Subscribe if you haven't already. It means the world to me. You guys are liking my video. Subscribe to the channel. You guys are the best. A Nightmare on Elm Street 2 Freddy's Revenge is a 1985 slasher film that is directed by Jack Sholder, with Wes Craven leaving the project due to creative differences within the script. This movie is a mixed bag for me, as I feel as though that there are elements to this movie that I enjoy if you take it as its own original horror film rather than a sequel to the original Nightmare on Elm Street. Since we already love and know Freddy Krueger for his powers, for what he's able to do, and they end up changing him, making him unscary, pretty laughable in a more contemporary sense. Patton is considered the first male scream queen because he is the only male that ends up being the main character in all these Nightmare on Elm Street films, as well as many other slasher films, as they mostly focus on that trope of the final girl. Most of this movie is, I would call, body horror. Some really cool ways of, like, scenes in the shower or scenes in his room. And they do it in a way where they have really cool makeup, costume design, and awesome practical and prosthetic effects that were still great in the original film, and that still feels like a Nightmare on Elm Street film and not just another Halloween or Friday the 13th. Like I was saying before, for its own horror movie, the concept is very cool. I think body horror is something that is very, very interesting because it almost seems so implausible to do, like someone taking over another body and you simply can't control it. It is something that's very scary and almost can be metaphorical if you do it in the right sense. They do a pretty solid job of maintaining that scary element and not being able to control the forces that are inside of you and still make it somewhat of a scary threat. But my issue is that if it wasn't Freddy Krueger, I think the movie would have been great because Freddy Krueger became so iconic from the first Elm Street movie, having his own design, having his own rules, and knowing how the character rolls and that how you can beat him or how he can absolutely tear you apart. The music's still good in this movie. It seems like they did change part of this music, and as most sequels do, they do change a little bit of the original music just to be a little bit different. It's okay. I think it's still solid and does make for a more atmospheric and dreamlike film. This movie does have a handful of negatives. There's a lot of goofy moments that are sprinkled throughout this movie, and I know that a lot of these older 80s slasher films are gonna have that, but I think even for its time, it was still considered very cheesy and super goofy, and there are some really unintentional, hilarious moments all the way through this movie that I found myself laughing so much. And not necessarily that it's so bad it's good way, like some of the other Nightmare on Elm Street films. Third act is absolutely garbage. It becomes something completely insane that it's not even body horror anymore. You just see Freddy Krueger running around killing people in the real world and not in their dreams. It absolutely betrays the character. It just feels so over the top, like the studio wanted to keep that original Freddy Krueger, like we see him in the first film, into the second. Wasn't buying anything that happened. The way they resolve the issue is completely stupid and makes no sense whatsoever. I feel like Freddy Krueger is just simply not a threat whatsoever, and he just seems so silly running around when everyone else seems way bigger than him. Amazing job handling that first film, as this one has some cool and adventurous scenes, especially with the kills aspect. I think those were directed well, but anytime it's just characters talking, it's just so bored because nothing with the camera is keeping us interested in what's happening. This film does have a lot of themes of homosexuality that was unintentionally added to this movie, but then we later find out that the writer actually had intentions of putting into this movie, but many of the cast members and the director had no idea that was happening. And so part of this movie had so many production problems with its script, being rushed into production, working crazy long hours, because this movie was released a year later than the first film. So they were just throwing this crap together, and I actually do enjoy many of those homosexual themes that are in this film, and I'm glad a lot of people are able to enjoy this film more because of those themes and saying that it's a gay horror movie. I think that's something that, you know, if you feel that pride in, or you feel like, you know, the movie is, you know, calling out, like, that in a way, I mean, I guess that's cool. That's overall, I think this is a fun, enjoyable movie at times throughout that has some great kills, and Freddy Krueger is still cool in this movie. There's a lot of cool body horror moments that I do enjoy, but this movie is filled with so many negatives, and it just betrays the character of Freddy Krueger. And overall, not a bad movie, but just a mediocre, average movie that just is forgettable for me. But I know a lot of people really enjoy this film, so I'm gonna give this film a 5 out of 10. Have you guys seen Freddy's Revenge? I wanna know anything about Nightmare on Elm Street or any of your rankings, all that down below. As always, see you guys in the next video.